What's good is Marcel J. I love that I always have to use this finger. What's good? Marcel J, back at it with a new reaction. Today I'm gonna react to a very talented, very new artist. I feel like isn't getting all of her respect right now for a couple of reasons. Her name is Noah Cyrus. If you don't know who she is, you most likely know her. Very famous, very talented, big sister Miley Cyrus. And I honestly, that's the only mention I want to make of Miley, because I think they are both very different artists. And, you know, just bring it all on the table. Let's start this conversation. It is very hard for artists that have famous siblings or famous parents to really be taken seriously in their own light. Like, they really do have to prove themselves on multiple levels. Like, don't get me wrong, I think it's nice. It's obviously nice to have that nice little platform jump of having a famous family to get you into the door, to get you that movie role, that song opportunity, the way to get there to prove yourself. But as soon as you prove yourself, you establish yourself as a serious artist, whether that be an actor, a singer, a writer, you should be able to, you know, let your talent shine. And that's what Noah's doing. Like, she's been in the game for a while. She was a child star actress. She was on Ponyo. Shout out to that dope movie. And I think people really started taking her seriously as an artist when she dropped Make Me Cry with, I believe Labyrinth. I will write down the actual artist if it's not Labyrinth, but yeah, they wrote that song together, dropped it. It's really dope. It's a really beautiful song. But more recently, last week, she dropped her EP, Good Cry. And if you know what's been going on with her and Lil Xan, had a lot of relationship drama play out online, in the blogs, on IG. And she's only like 19. At oldest, she's 19. I feel like she might be younger. Actually, I have it right here. 18. She's only 18 years old. Her career is just starting. Her life, her adult life is just starting. And she has a lot of emotions and a lot of shit to get off her chest. And that's what Good Cry is. And we're going to get into the title track of the EP, Good Cry. Honestly, my favorite song from the EP. I won't say anything else, but if you aren't a Noah Cyrus fan, give it a chance, give her a shot. Like, she is really fucking talented. So let's get into Good Cry. I'm also eating oatmeal, so this looked kind of a mukbang. Excuse any, like, you know, spoonfuls of oatmeal going through my mouth. Let's go. Pause real quick. So she sets the scene with that, honestly, I want to say dramatic drum, that beat, that boom, tss, boom, boom. Tss. Then it has like that jazz vibe to it. And with the opening lyrics, she's in a bar, drinking her feelings away. She's 18. The only thing it's like very bittersweet for me right now, because I feel like when it came to younger artists of the past, especially like the teen Disney Channel Nickelodeon stars, they really had to have that squeaky clean image to maybe their mid-20s or like 21 beyond, when they were ready for their adult audience. And then they had to get super vulgar and sexual and just like really push themselves out of their whole Disney Channel persona. But with this, Noah's just being herself from the jump. Being 18 years old, I remember being in college, I was drinking, I was doing a lot of adult shit that I shouldn't have been doing. So it feels authentic in that sense. But when I think of this song being played out in a music video or something, I feel like she's not gonna be in a bar doing her thing. And like, I kind of wish she'd be able to legally showcase that experience of being depressed and feeling like you can drink your feelings away when you never can, just numbs it. But yeah, the song opens with her being in a bar. Bartender says she should go home, but she doesn't want to be alone. Like, her voice, the way that she wrote this song is so fucking real, man. What I love most about this EP, and I love most about this song, Good Cry, is that we all have that moment where we're trying to get over a relationship, we're trying to get over something serious, a serious connection that we had with someone, and all we need to do is just let our feelings out. You know, maybe that's a good cry. Maybe it's a good drink. Maybe that's a good hookup with someone else. But we just can't get our mind off that person who really broke us. Let's continue. Cigarette smoke all in my space. I can't find my old self through the haze. I'm searching dust to dawn. I guess that girl is gone. Reality, it's like a trend. The chorus hits. And her voice has so much, like, a perfect amount of emotion for this song. Such a solid chorus, like that's a sing-along chorus. If this song gets like big, the level that I really want it to be, I could picture people just drunkenly singing this shit at a karaoke bar. Like that's what the vibe, that's the vibe that reminds me of, kind of. But it also reminds me, different sounds definitely, but it reminds me of Solange's Crimson of the Sky, when she's like, I tried to drink it away, I tried to fuck it away, I tried to smoke it away, but you just can't. You can't get rid of your feelings. Like, you just have to live through them. Even though Noah is very young, I think she understands that. And this music is her therapy. It's her way of letting all that stuff out. I just really fuck with the song. Let's keep going. I've been up 6 days and five nights. Insomnia, very relatable. I was all up in my head, just me, myself. I love how simple the production is and the music, the background. Just let it lets the lyrics and the vocals just shine. And this is really impressive for her first official EP. Her like just I fuck with this EP so much, so heavy. But this song, it's gonna get me through some shit. I can feel it. Whenever an artist is a woo, you know they felt all that shit and it's just out and they feel good. I also have to mention, like, Noah has a very unique voice, and I think it's because her voice is so different. It either gets adored or criticized. Like, people love it or hate it. I love it personally, you might hate it, but at least she's trying to sound unique. At least she's trying to, not even trying to sound unique, but she's trying to put her most authentic self out there. Because it's easier, because it would have been easy for her to ride the coattails of, like, make me cry, and then she had to stay together. We are. She had a couple of, like, party, kind of generic type songs that sounded good for her, but didn't have that much emotional depth in them. So I'm glad that this is the direction she's going into. If for this is just to be the EP, like, I cannot wait to hear what the album sounds like. Let's finish this song off. That's good cry. I fucks with it, I love it. I really hope there's a music video coming. If you haven't heard the EP, definitely check it out. It's only like 5 or 6 songs, but if you don't want to hear the full like 5 or 6 songs, definitely listen to Good Cry again. Give it the full attention it deserves. Also listen to Mad at You featuring Galliant, Topanga. It's like she recorded the song off her voice memo, so it's just her and a guitar, and it sounds so beautiful. And it also tells a very great story. Yeah, just getting to this artist. I love Singer. I've said it in my past video for Doja Cat. Yeah, I'm gonna be reacting to a couple of more singer-songwriters, but I just love people who know how to like push their pen and just tell some really dope, very emotional, amazing stories with their songs. So shout out to Noah, getting a good cry. That's all I have to say for today. If you enjoyed the video, also if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. I'm Russell J. Thank you for checking me out. On to the next video.